Dear learners, welcome to the last video in this series on Swayam. Here, we will discuss about developing a proposal to make a MOOC available on Swayam and the content development for a Swayam MOOC. Let's take a quick glance at the topics that we will cover in this video. We discuss about how the course coordinators are identified by national coordinators and how the proposal for a MOOC is developed. We shall also talk about the different aspects that need to be incorporated in the course proposal. Lastly, we shall also take a look at the evaluation methodology and the grading scheme. There are broadly three steps in the identification of a course coordinator by the national coordinators. The national coordinator first identifies those courses where online education is possible and preferred. These courses are then advertised in newspapers and other media calling for expression of interest. In the identified courses, expression of interest, which is popularly called as EOI, are invited for credit courses from course coordinator through recognized universities, institute of national importance, and other educational institutions authorized to award degrees and credits, and from subject specialists, both in public and private sectors, for non-credit courses. After evaluating the EOIs received, the national coordinators shall appoint a course coordinator. Now, let's look at the conditions of a course coordinator must adhere to. The course coordinator, while submitting expression of interest, shall also submit an undertaking from a host university or institution conveying its willingness to offer the course for credit, conduct examination, assessment, evaluation, issue certificates, and transfer the credits to the students of the parent university or institution as per the UGC, AICT, or any other regulatory body regulations issued for the purpose. The course coordinators are identified for each course based on the quality of the sample content, reputation of the expert, institute, and teaching learning methods proposed, and invite him or her to prepare the MOOC within 6 months from the date. The national coordinators shall ensure that no further courses are allotted to the course coordinator unless he or she has successfully completed a course allotted earlier. In case two or more course coordinators from the same institution drop, discontinue courses at a given time, the host institution shall be denied further participation for the stipulated time. In case the selected course coordinator is a private person or a private institution not entitled to award credits, certificates, it shall identify a public institution authorized to offer credits, certificates, for the course and issue certificate as co-applicant. An MOU between two defining their roles will be formulated and later approved by the national coordinator or Swayam board. At the time of proposal, there are a few things that need to be specified about the course. It must be stated that whether the course is credit or non-credit type course. The title of the course must be stated and a brief overview should be given. it should help the learner to counter the questions like, what is the course about? What does the course include? What will I learn in the course? How do I use the course features, the medium of instruction, as well as the course schedule and duration should be mentioned in the proposal. It must also debunk the details of the instructional videos, reading materials, assessment systems, and discussion forums. Once the courses are ready to be developed as e-content, they must be repurposed. While repurposing, the broad objectives of the course must be clearly stated. The expected learning outcomes from the courses must be discussed, and prerequisites for the course must be enlisted. Course objectives and module objectives in terms of performance outcomes will be expressed as the output of the task. Performance objectives may be many, and each objectives will express the learner's achievement only in one small area. These steps will help the learners in decision making and choosing the right course for them. A brief introductory video may be added while repurposing the course. The video's duration can be 2 to 5 minutes, and it must be done preferably by the course coordinator. In the introductory video, the course coordinator must give a brief overview of the course, state the course objectives, and summarize the course content along with the prerequisites and learning outcomes. While stating the learning outcomes in any course, the course coordinator must specify each of the outcomes in detail so that it may ultimately help the learner grasp a better understanding of the course. The topics covered in the course, the module developed on these topics, and the themes in each of them should be made clear by the course coordinator. The teaching team comprising of a course coordinator and co-coordinator is of primary importance. Their basic information like a photograph, contact details, and brief in about 40 words may be provided. These elements may be included in the course landing page. It is important for the course coordinator to set and specify the eligibility criteria of the learner to get admission to a course. The minimum educational qualification and prerequisites sought from the learner to enroll in the course should be specified. While repurposing a course into a MOOC, the course coordinator should be able to define the target audience. It is a pre-planning factor which can essentially decide the number of learners that might be interested in enrolling for the course and can effectively improve the completion rate. Defining the target audience and stating the prerequisites will help to clear misconceptions in the learner's mind by helping them decide if the course would be of any significant help to them and make the course more transparent. When the course coordinator defines the course cycle, there are a few factors that must be specified. The number of times a course is open in a year should be clarified so that students can choose the right window to pick the course. The important dates such as course announcement date, start date, and end date should be specified so that the learner can plan their academic ventures as per the schedule and avoid overlapping. Given below is a list of details to be provided by the course coordinator regarding the video lectures, reading materials, and assessment. The video lectures must have a title, a content abstract, and specify the name of the teacher. The duration of the video should be stated in minutes, and the date on which the video will be open to the learners should also be mentioned. The details of the reading material should specify the name of the author and its type of publication for X articles, notes, etc. It must also have a content abstract and should mention the number of pages. The assessment details should specify the type of assessment, the topic covered, the date schedule for them, and the maximum marks that can be obtained. It is mandatory for all the video lectures to have a documented transcript. A 4-credit course must ideally include 40 videos of half an hour each. That adds up to a total of 20 hours. The reading materials of the same course maybe have up to 40 modules with a definite word limit. When the evaluation methodology is formulated, the overall assessment strategy and the assessment procedure of the host institute is taken into consideration. It may include formative and summative assessment and regard course completion as a level of achievement. Keeping these factors in focus, a grading scheme is developed, and it may include assignments, quizzes, practicals, project works, and a final exam based on which the learner will be evaluated. Although the Swayam MOOC platform is a boon for the learners, there are still a few challenges that need to be overcome to make things better. As of now, Swayam is only limited to individual courses and doesn't offer a complete curriculum yet. The maximum credit that can be earned through the platform for any program is just 20%. Merely providing the learning content doesn't guarantee a wholesome learning experience. A lot of factors contribute to providing the learners with the best learning experiences, and these must be incorporated into the system. There is an urgent need to scale up individualized and group mentoring to help the learners better. The low completion rate at Swayam is a cause of worry and cannot be overlooked if the problem on the platform is to be a part of the education system in the future, where online learning must probably be the norm. Merely providing the learning content doesn't guarantee a wholesome learning experience. A lot of factors contribute to providing the learners with the best learning experiences, and these must be incorporated into the system. There is an urgent need to scale up individualized and group mentoring to help the learners better. The low completion rate at Swayam is a cause of worry and cannot be overlooked. If the platform is to be a part of the education system in the future, where online learning would must probably be the norm. For things to function glitch-free in SWAM MOOCs, there must be a good coordination between the parent and host institute. This will facilitate the smooth transfer of credits and other procedures. Given here is a list of the websites and documents that were referred to and have been helpful in the making of this video lecture series on SWAM MOOCs. Given here a list of the websites and the documents that were referred to and have been helpful in the making of this video lecture series on SWAM MOOCs. Thank you for watching this video.